It's September 15th, 2013. We're starting at a little before where the 1985 video was taken. This is the top of New Hempstead Road, headed east toward New City. You'll see that there's some work going on. It's been ongoing for about 2 years, and it's been kind of a traffic nightmare in town. With the two hurricanes in the past couple of years, it set back the progress, and I think they still have another year or so to go. The utility companies fell behind moving the wires from the old poles to the new ones, and we're still stuck with this for a while to come. Right up here, we're coming up to the intersection with Joan Drive on the left, I believe. New City is still a great place to raise a family. I think the number one complaint that anyone would have would be the outrageous taxes we pay here. Okay, on the right is Havermill Road. And here we're reaching the point where the project's been completed. From this point down to Main Street, New City, they're completely finished with it. They still have some maintenance to do on the side of the road, but it does look pretty good. On the right-hand side, they moved the stone pillars from the original sheriff's office over to the entrance of Demarest Kill Park, which was the Greenberg property years ago. And as we come up around the bend, you may see they have actually made it not as steep, and they've straightened out the curve a little bit. Okay, now we're approaching Main Street, New City, the shopping center up front, which everyone from New City would remember. There's not really anything left from years ago, I think, except for maybe the Carvel ice cream shop over on the right-hand side. And up toward the corner there is the Kevin Landau Memorial Park, which was completely redone a couple years ago as part of the Main Street project. And on Main Street, lots of businesses have come and gone over the years. Up on, I believe up on the left here was a hardware store at one time. The old post office was on the right side, Mario's Pizza on the left here. It's still a pizza restaurant. Sal's Barbershop, which was in the 85 video, is still on the left. And on the right is Starbucks, where Friendly's was at one time. And this vacant lot on the right is where the Getty Station was in the 85 video. This is St. Augustine's School, which closed down in June, and the new St. Augustine Church. And up on the right, the old pumpkin building, as we used to call it, because it was orange, and it was repainted many years ago. Now, up on the right, although it doesn't appear in the video, there's actually a bank where Blimpie's was, and I think it was a diner at one time. It was like a little, like the old-fashioned 50s design, like a sort of like a railroad car design. You could just catch a glimpse of it. Over on the left is the Clarkstown Shopping Plaza, where Grand Union was, and Maximus, of course. I remember there being an auto parts store over there. On the right there was the clubhouse, which was Peasant's Pot. And you can see that they're right in the middle of repaving the road here. And coming up on the left is the old A&P shopping center. Years ago, I had worked in a Pizza Hut that was on the right corner of this shopping center. And there's La Terraza restaurant, which years ago was the White Cap Inn, and later A Matter of Taste. And Higgins Funeral Home and St. Paul's on your right. Okay, and as if you were going to go straight ahead right here, that's where the four-star steakhouse was. There's a little strip center down there, and where the steakhouse actually was is a restaurant called the Burger Loft, which is, it's actually pretty good. And here on the right-hand side in the 85 video, these condos were just under construction. You really can't see them too well from the road anymore. And on the left is where the Texaco station and Willowbrook dairy stand was. Actually, I thought, yeah, we're not going to be able to catch a look at that. Now heading south on 304. Up on the left, there's a restaurant called Hard Rock Buffet, which years ago was the Town Tavern, which my family spent a lot of time in. And next to that, you'll see very quickly is a liquor store, which was a Kentucky Fried Chicken up until a few years ago. There's the Hard Walk and the liquor store. And now we're at the corner of 304 and Germans Road, still headed south. Albertus Magnus High School, where I graduated from, is off to the left, but can't get a picture of it because of the trees. We're following really the exact same path as we did in the 1985 video. Maybe with a couple little additions. Coming up on the right is a senior citizens complex called Monterey Gardens, and I believe years ago it was Monterey Swim Club. I'm not 100% sure of that, but I'm pretty sure it was located right over here. And now we're moving towards the Bardonia Road and Ludwig Road intersection with 304. Over on the left, there's a strip center with Bardonia Pharmacy, and there's some gas station, old bank that they're going to be taking down to build a CVS. Lock, Stock, and Barrel is long gone. It was replaced, I think, with the Credit Union building. This little building, I think, was a gas station in the 85 video. And behind that is the building that was Schlott Realtors back then. And this is the... That's the whole area. They're taking all those buildings down, including the apartment building in the back. Now we're cutting ahead a little. This is... We're approaching Middletown Road at the head of Ludwig Road. That's a relatively new traffic light, now that I think of it. I don't get down here too often. Now headed south on Middletown Road. This is the thruway underpass that used to have the bicentennial decorations on it. Up ahead, you'll see the former Huffman Coos furniture store. I don't know if there's anything in there now. It's been a lot of different things over the years. There's a little restaurant called the Dog House, where the barn used to be. Some of you may remember the barn. I've only heard stories. Here is the corner of 59 and Middletown Road. You can't see the building over there. In the old video, it was a pickles restaurant. I think prior to that, it was called Bagel Nosh. And I think it was vacant for a number of years, but there's a bank there present day. In the old video, it you had all the strip malls lining 59 sometime in the late 80s, I guess. They widened 59, took out all the buildings, and for many years the only building standing over there was a house on the corner of 59 owned by Mrs. Ferretti, or Miss Ferretti, and they took that down, I want to say, 6 months ago, finally. Up where the Nanuet Mall used to be, they're currently reaching the end of construction on a shopping center called the Shops at Nanuet. It's supposed to open next month, I believe, which will hopefully breathe some economic life into Nanuet, but at the same time, it's going to have some impact on traffic in this area. Yeah, they're making good progress here. They're almost done. Now, on the right is the old Granway Shopping Center from many years ago. There's that bank that was Bagel Nosh. On the right is where Granway was. Later, there was a Rock Bottom drugstore, I guess, a little further down was Grant's, for those of you who grew up in the 60s and 70s. Later, Grant's became Child World, which was that was in the 85 video. Now there's a whole group of smaller stores in there, including Barnes & Noble, a health food store. I believe that they actually extended the end of the building a number of years ago. And next is the former Plaza Diner, now called the Nanuet Diner. I haven't been there in years. And behind that, coming up is, it was a lighting store in the 85 video, and years ago it was a bowling alley. Maple Ways, I think it was called. And now it's a Goodwill store and a mattress shop. And there's White Castle, still there. And here where Ground Round used to stand is a Hyundai dealership. Up on the right there, there was a day camp there. If you make a right onto this road, it was one time a residential street, but they took all those out, and there's a Home Depot and a furniture store back there. And here's Red Lobster. And next to that is the Verizon phone store. In the old video, there's about a half second, you can see the old Reese Beverage building. That's where my father used to get all our soda and get his beer. Over sort of towards the left would be where Cleats and Sneaks still is. And there's a bunch of stores in there. I couldn't quite get a shot of that. there was a motel on the left hand side in the mid-80s that went, and I'm not even sure exactly where it was, so I couldn't tell you what's in there now. And there were a bunch of smaller stores and such lining 59 here that went out to build, like the Staples, and up where the Holiday Inn used to be, they put up two larger hotels. One is a Hilton Garden Inn, and the other one is, I'm not sure, we're going to have to get a closer look. If you make a right here, that's where Deuce Coupe was. A Hampton Inn, okay. So this is the old throughway entrance. The shopping center, everyone will remember it because that's where the Route 59 theater was years ago. Now, just small stores, a couple pawn shops right along here. The old Howard Johnson's was on the left. It's now a Days Inn. And now we're approaching an area that in 1985 there was basically nothing there. Aside from the road to the tunnel. And I would say, really, probably within a year or two after that 1980 video was taken, they built the Spring Valley Marketplace, which is on the right. And they put New Clarkstown Road through to West Clarkstown Road. At this point in the old video, I took a picture of a plane that was taking off from the Round Po Airport, which hasn't been there for, I don't know, 25 years. This spot is usually good for a little bottleneck. Okay, now we're making the left on Perlman Drive. Which takes us up here to Pascack Road, and that's obviously it'll be the road to the tunnel. Okay, here we're coming up on the intersection of Pascack and Smith Road. If you make a right on Smith Road, that takes you by where the airport was. The runway for the old airport is approximately where the parking lot is for a new Costco and Lowe's, which is up there. Well, not new, but newer than 85. I think they've been there maybe 5 years or so. and continuing along here, it doesn't look like there's been a lot going on here, because this is the Clarkstown. That's one thing they added. It's a community center that you access off of New Clarkstown Road. But the houses in this area were built in the 50s and 60s, and so essentially it looks the same. Okay, jumping ahead. Now this is the Rockland Lane, I guess. Eckerson Road. We just made a left onto Eckerson Road here, heading up into in the Hillcrest. And there's a little shopping center up here on the left. I remember there being a coin store years ago there. I used to ride up from New City once in a while and hunt around in there. And up here on the corner, there's one vacant lot, but there's still a gas station across the street. There's the Hillcrest shopping center. Pull over and we'll get a better shot of that. Remember there being a Hebrew National in there? That stationery store was there years ago. That was Grand Union. And let's see. I don't remember too much else from up here. I went to St. Joseph's Elementary School, so I used to come up here with my friends once in a while. In the next shopping center there used to be a Waldbaum's. And let's see, coming up on the right will be where Leota Bakery was one time. It's actually a church now. Okay, headed north on Route 45. Coming up on the right is, try to get a glimpse of it. It was a stone structure that was Hillcrest Beverages. And in my high school days, I can remember that anyone with money could get beer there, regardless of age. Not that I knew by personal experience, but yeah, that's where it was. And although this part may look the same, there's been a lot of construction of homes and so forth that are sort of right near the edge, and you really can't see them from the car. We're going to be approaching here the village of New Square, which is probably the area that's grown more than any in Rockland County. And you'll see, there's a lot of buildings and so forth. The old Ramapo Hospital is off to the right, among many new buildings that have been put up since 85. Yeah, there was a gas station on that corner in the old video. And you can just sort of make out the old hospital. And there's a huge health center behind it. And I guess this is a catering hall or a community center there. And just it stretches here. There's a lot of a lot of close residential construction. Just missed the old Volkswagen dealership that was in the old video is now a campus of Camp Venture, which is an organization that helps people who are disabled. And now we'll be turning right onto New Hempstead Road. And headed back toward the beginning point. Again, there's a lot of housing developments off to either, especially on the left side, that weren't there, but you really can't make it out from the road. And now we're headed back into the work zone here. And on the left there is the Grace Point church, which I've been told is the largest church in the county. I don't know if it's true, and I heard that. And here's the intersection with Buena Vista Road. Off to the left is where the Hilltop Deli is. It's in a new building. They put up a strip center maybe 13, 14 years ago. On the left, you're really not going to be able to make it out, I don't think, is what was the Hebrew Gittleman Day School, and it had recently changed hands, and I don't remember the name offhand. Adolf Schreiber, I think it looks like. Now, Sycamore Drive off to the left here is the neighborhood that I actually grew up in. And here we are, back to the beginning. And I think we're going to take a ride through New City going in the opposite direction just for those who might be interested in that. Okay, here we're headed north on Main Street. That's always been one bank or another. Years ago, and that store was Mama Louise's Pizza, Monley Chinese Takeout. There was a trophy store, as I remember. And what else? There was like it was called High Health. I think it was a convenience store. And that's where AMP was. And there was a house taken out there to put that building in maybe 10 years ago. That's probably more now. City Line Restaurant. Pretty popular place in New City. And now we're back at the Clarkstown Shopping Center. Spent a lot of time there as a kid. Yep, Maximus. What was Maximus is a mortgage loan office. Rocco's that's been there for 30 years. That, for those who remember, that was the old Carol's restaurant. And here is St. Augustine again, and the church and the school. Still a couple houses left on Main Street. Was and back to Congress Road. So I hope you enjoyed it. If anyone has any ideas or something else they want to see, just let me know. I live in town. I'd be glad to go out and spend an afternoon shooting something that somebody's interested in.